So hey, what's going on YouTube? So I recently came down to the discovery that DaVinci Resolve has finally made an app for the iPad Pro. I'm gonna let you know this is my first time ever opening the app, and I'm only gonna be color grading, not editing, because that's basically what I use DaVinci Resolve for in my regular workflow. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that here. Before I bought my MacBook Pro, I bought the iPad Pro in thoughts that I can edit video on it, just to come down to the disappointment that there wasn't necessarily any NLEs available to edit videos. Now, NLEs that I use is Final Cut, Premiere Pro, and DaVinci Resolve. So as a side note, before I open this app, there's a few things that I would mention prior to installing the app. For one, this is a 2 GB app. Another thing to note as well too, you need iOS 16 in order to operate this application. So enough rambling on, and let's go ahead and open up the app and see what it entails. So the first thing that you will see is basically what you will see on the desktop app. As you can notice the difference down below, it's only 2 tabs, which is the editing tab and the color grading tab. What we're gonna be focusing on is the color grading tab. I'm gonna also mention I have my CF Express fast card attached to the iPad via USB-C. Now, another interesting thing to note as well, it didn't ask for any credentials of mine. I have the DaVinci Resolve Studio version on my desktop, and I would assume that, you know, it would ask me for the same kind of information upon opening this app, but it seems like this is a 100% free app. Maybe they're going to provide you with a, you know, Studio version for iPad as well. But as far as I'm concerned, in December 2022, I guess this is a free app. Let's go ahead and see how easy and, you know, user-friendly this application is. So the first thing I'm gonna do is with my fingerprint, because I do not have an Apple Pencil, is tap import. Now, it was very simple. I guess the first thing it'll show you is all the drives available. I'm going to go ahead and tap on EOS Digital, and I'm gonna import this file right here by tapping it with my fingerprint again. Of course, you could select multiple media information, but I just want this particular media. So I'm gonna press open. Now, the next thing it usually does is it asks you if you wanted to change your frame rate. I already went ahead and did that ahead of time. I'm gonna go ahead and drag my media. You could see that there is black bars above and beneath the video. That's basically telling you that the clip size isn't the same as the timeline size. So I'm just gonna assume that this little cogwheel at the bottom right hand side is what's gonna allow you to change the settings of your project. I also came down to the discovery that it has limitations on the size as well too. This being an 8K footage, you don't have the option to edit in an 8K timeline, which is also a limitation as well. Like I mentioned, this is a free app so far, since that's the closest thing to my aspect ratio for this video. So I'm gonna press save. So be mindful that there's no 8K editing in the timeline, at least in this free version so far. Let's go ahead and go into the color tab, because that's what I want to focus on. And I don't see too much of a difference in their color tab as well. Of course, they still have their node tree, which is interesting. And let's see if we can name our project. I just tapped on untitled project. I'm gonna name this backyard. And let's see how the saving option works. Now, I'm gonna be honest with you, I have no clue where this project's being saved. I'm assuming it's gonna be saved in my iCloud or wherever. Usually when I'm color grading, I like to have as much real estate as possible. And this is too small of a screen for me to actually make any true color grading decisions. So I'm gonna tap on the clip so we can eliminate the clip, because we only have one clip. And let's see if it has the same options as you have in the Studio version. So I'm gonna go ahead and drag this video to where I could see my color checker, and it's in focus, which would be right here. And let's see if the color grading is similar to what you would see in the desktop version. So I usually like to start my color grading with color space transform or an ASIS transform, which the option is here. interesting. If you had the desktop version, that would be something that would only be available in the studio version, but it seems like in this free version, we have it available to us here. So let's go to effects again. Now let's go ahead and adjust the parameters. That's a good way to start. And let's go ahead and go back into the cog wheel and adjust our settings too. Let's see, color management, DaVinci YRGB, that's fine. Timeline, color space, Rec 709. And let's go ahead and change that to the gamma, if I can find it. It seems like the options aren't limited here. Rec 709, gamma 2.4, there it is. Now I have the color management exactly where I want it. Camera raw, it seems like it's grayed out, the raw profile. So maybe you can only edit in Blackmagic raw when it comes down to the iPad version. Like I said, this is basically my first time, you know, using this app as well. So I'm experimenting just as you guys are watching this video. Okay, everything seems fine so far, and this is a good grade start. Now, the next thing I like to do is adjust the exposure. Maybe it's this. Oh, there you go. I realize, you see where the hand and the mouse cursor is? To the right of that, you'll see that there's two squares. That's where you add a new node. So I'm going to change the parade by tapping on parade and go to waveform. Turn off colorize. I don't need colorize for my waveform. Now let's see how the power grade window works. So okay, I tapped on the square. I only needed to focus on my exposure part of my color checker. So how do I isolate that? I know on the keyboard usually is Shift H. So how do we do that here? Oh, there you go. So basically, if you're on the left-hand corner, the top left-hand, there's three options next to the percentage, which is 53. It's going to be your third option. You tap on that and then you isolate your power grade. Now, usually I like to use the HDR instead of the primary color wheels, but we're just going to go ahead and run through it quickly and do a quick grade. So we're going to adjust it to our liking. Of course, we're going to turn off our power grade because we don't need it anymore. That seems like a pretty fair. It's a little crushed. I never really like crushing my blacks too much. So that seems like a pretty good exposure. Now, the next thing we're going to do is create a new node, and we're going to adjust the temperature along the tint to make sure we have a pretty accurate white balance. So once again, we're going to create a new power grade and go after the white and the, oh, I accidentally dragged that, the white and the gray. And I'm not gonna lie to you, I'm really liking this app so far. It seems pretty smooth and easy, and I assume it'd be a little slow in comparison to my desktop app, but it seems to be moving just as fast. So we're going to isolate that and get our white balance. We're going to go ahead and change to the vector scope, and I could see that it's fairly white balanced, but it's a little bit on the warm side. So let's go ahead and adjust the temperature and the tint to get it accurate. This image was definitely not balanced properly. That seems a little bit more accurate. So let's go back to the power grade and let's turn it off. And let's turn off our power grade. And okay, it looks graded a lot better. So now that we got our exposure along with our color balance a little bit more accurate, let's go ahead and get our colors accurate as well too. So I'm gonna go ahead and create a new note. I'm very heavy on the power grades because I use my color checker a lot. So how do I zoom in? Of course, I'm gonna tap right there. I'm gonna zoom in probably 75%. If anything, 100%. To be honest with you, my fingers are a little bit too big to adjust the feathering. You're dealing with a small screen in comparison to using a mouse. So let's go ahead and get it a little bit more accurate. And let's go into our curves and adjust our hues. Now, let's go ahead and adjust the vector scope so we could see a little bit more clearly. So we need the vector scope, and I like to use the two times. And since there's no skin tones here, I'm not gonna turn on the skin tone indicator, but I will show the 2x zoom, bring the vector scope all the way up, and let's adjust our colors. Let's see how easy that is. So, of course, on the desktop version, you would automatically have the eyedropper tool where you could just tap on the colors. Let's see if we could do that here. Oh, yep, I tapped on the yellow and it got me to the yellow. And let's adjust our yellows. Let's see how easy it is using it with your fingertips. Okay, it seems kind of easy as well too, or you could use the hue rotation. So let's adjust it using the hue rotation. Let's see how easy it is with that. Yeah, yo, to be honest with you, this is a very smooth application. Let me go ahead and adjust these colors, I'm trying to get these into the center of the square. And let's turn off the power window. Let's zoom out. Now we're pinching our fingertips to zoom out. And let's just say we're satisfied with this grade. Now let's see how the export button works. Let me just go ahead and create a new node and sharpen it a little bit. Bring it down to 49. Like I said, it's kind of, you see, I'm trying to hit 49. It's kind of difficult with as big as my fingertips are. You see, now I can't even get it to the 49. Okay, there we go. It keeps going back to 48. Whenever I release my fingertips, it hits 48. I'm trying to get it to 40. There you go. All right, so let's go ahead and export it. It seems like your options of exporting are limited as well too, which is an H.264, H.265, or these presets for these certain applications. Let me do H.264 because that's something I would use for YouTube. And I see that you can actually sign in to your internet accounts, but we're not going to do that. And we're going to tap on export, but here are basically your export options. And then you export it to your iCloud. Let's export it to our EOS Digital. Press save, and let's see how long it takes. Okay, it's pretty fast. And bada bing, bada boom, wa bam. And that's basically my first time ever using the iPad for DaVinci Resolve color grading. And to be honest with you, if I was to grade this, I'll definitely give it an 8 out of 10. Only because it was a little, you know, difficult to use my fingertips to pinch and find certain things. But if you play around with it and you look around, it seems like it's kind of, if not very similar to the desktop app. And DaVinci, you did a really good job with this app, and I'm very proud of you guys. And you guys never cease to disappoint. Well, that's basically it. My real name's Kit. Hopefully you guys like, share, and subscribe. You already know the vibes. I'm out, and deuces.